Hello, dissenters. My name is Etalyx, and I am here today to welcome you to the beautiful world of Trine 3, just released on Steam Early Access today for $18. You might be thinking, Etalyx, did you just say Trine 3 on Early Access of all things? What will be next? I don't know, guys. I don't know. I agree, it's weird. But it is the way of things nowadays, and the developers at least have an explanation as to why this has come out to early access, for those of you who might immediately be scared and worried for your favorite series, Survival, or however you like it, doesn't matter. The point is, on Steam Early Access, they hope to learn from gamers what they like and dislike about the new, more open 3D environments. It's a lot less side-scrolly than Trine has been in the past, and Trine 1 and 2, but that being said, it is still very much primarily a left-to-right style game. But it just has a lot more openness to it, a lot more breathing room, and a lot less claustrophobic as a result. We are here on my second mission of the game. We started off as the warrior hero, and now we have the Assassin's Creed-esque archer. I really like this character because of her mobility. She can, of course, shoot ranged arrows at things that might be floating above to try to find hidden collectibles, such as what we are picking up here. Collecting enough of these, we have, what, 150 total, it looks like? I don't know what happens if you get more of them. All I know is I am so addicted to gathering up as many of these as I can. Sometimes in games, collectibles, I try to avoid them and pass them up just because I don't see the point, but here, collecting them is a reward in and of itself, as difficult as that is to say. Just trying to figure out the puzzle pieces is where I get my enjoyment and fun out of these little orange triangular shapes. I don't know exactly what they are. Pyramids. Let's call them pyramids. I don't know how to get this one. It's got me a little bit stumped. Okay, Etalyx, just focus. Use your gamer sense. Shooting it doesn't do anything. You can't attack it with melee. You can't shoot an arrow at the little bar on the top. Perhaps we use this platform to jump on. Yes! That is exactly it. See what I mean? It's simple. It's simple, but so enjoyable. This game is joy. Is that a bad thing to equate it to? Possibly, maybe it's giving it too much credit, but I just really have enjoyed Trine's gameplay in the past. Okay, I think I can remember what this character's name is. Is it Soya? I think it's Soya. Break these spears. So you might be thinking, Etalyx, what do I get for the price of admission here in Early Access? And the answer is not much. According to the Early Access page, you get about a couple levels. So you're probably gonna beat that fairly quickly. Now, to the developer's credit, they do have Trine 1 and 2 as completed games in their record. You know, they have a history is what I'm trying to say. Also, what is that guy doing? Can I catch him? How do I do that? $18 for a couple levels, not a lot. I would not fault you whatsoever for wanting to wait to see what you can get. Whoa, I pushed X and I latched on to a giant ring up above. Probably gonna need to use that to swing upwards. Let's see. So this is the second level, so I'm assuming that this is the last one. I don't know, maybe there's another one after this and this is technically the tutorial. I haven't figured out the specifics yet of what they consider to be levels or not. The point is, not a whole lot there in its current state. This is very, very much about supporting the developers early on. You might be thinking, Etalyx, why do they need the money? Well, like I said earlier, they're trying out some newer, more 3D environments. Kinda like you're seeing here, swinging through these huge, open, beautiful environments. Sure, it's still funneling you down one specific path. It's not open world by any means. But that being said, it's just a better experience reaching that destination with this new, more open nature. Well, getting up onto this platform is not the hard part. The hard part is figuring out how to get behind it. There we go. Much better. Let's move on to the next area. Like I said, so far, I think you'll kind of know off the top of your head whether or not this is a game for you, whether or not you have to play it or not. For those of you who are not invested in Trine or don't really care about another platformer, yes, probably waiting is the best course of action just to see how much content is in the game, because the worry, the fear is always, is the game going to be as long as the developers say it's going to be? Hey, so that's how you climb. Okay, I forgot, it's been a while. Let's swing on over, grab another piece of the puzzle, and it looks like this can almost fall down, but maybe not. Either way, level design's great. The visuals are especially astounding in my opinion. I love the color scheme. The purples mixing with the greens here. The last level was a lot of farmland playing as the knight character. We gotta drag this apparently with a rope. So let's go ahead and snag it. There's our physics-based gameplay that we miss so dearly. Open up the snake's mouth. And I wanna check in the corners just to make sure I'm not missing anything else. These environments can be pretty big, deceptively so. So when you enter a new area, you really do need to go press your corners as far as you can just to make sure that you're not missing anything on the side. Oh, yeah, I thought there would be something to swing on up there. Apparently, that was not the case. So let's see how reloading checkpoints and lives work in the game. Hey, just throws me right back here. Nothing really to be that concerned about. Probably gonna have to shimmy. Yep, that's plan B. Should have done that the first time. So I really honestly can't wait to see more content here in Trine 3. I would love to play through this whole game right now. I'm really, really just in the mood for it. It has a nimbleness to it that other platformers don't. The physics-based running and movement is good as well. The flowing cloth behind her looks awesome. Of course, there's some clipping, but that's okay. Generally speaking, the characters feel really loose and fluid the first time that I controlled them. And they felt imprecise, but the more I've been playing, the better it has started to feel. So let's see if we can wall jump over to this other side. There we go, and one more up. It's puzzles like this that make me truly enjoy trying. This is why. If you don't think this looks cool, you're not gonna like this game. It's pretty much that simple. So we're gonna hit Y here to attach a rope to this platform, which I have to pull towards me. Now, when I go back, it also goes back. So there's no way for me to jump onto it to move over to the other side. So we have to go and latch it onto another little ring. So now that it's here, not only is it stable, but if I want to, I can shoot it. I can break the rope with my own arrows. I love how interactable everything in the environment is. And that's primarily where I derive most of the joy that I get from the game itself. Just the exploration, the experimentation with the different mechanics, and learning how all the systems interact with one another. More than that, guys, the whole game is playable in co-op. Not only local co-op, but also online, so you can play with up to two other friends if you all have the game. I guess I need to hit Y and pull this off of the ledge. There we go. Playing in co-op right now, according to the developers, is a bit buggy, guys, in its online form at the moment, so I guess they're gonna be working on some bug fixes and other things of that nature. But local co-op should work a lot more flawlessly. Either way, I'm assuming that you play as a different character each guy. So there's the wizard, the warrior, and we have the archer here, of course. Where do I go next? Unfortunately, learning how to open the door is not good enough. We have to figure out how to keep it open. So let's try making the rope a little bit longer. Can we pull it around the side somehow? So close. I think I'm on the right track here. Okay, there's clearly a puzzle here, and I think I'm right on the cusp of figuring it out. Instead of the backmost pillar, let's try the closer pillar. Give it some slack. Aha! Okay, now you won't lock me out. You're gonna lock me in. And I'm gonna take your green gem, little parrot. That is mine. No, just shoot the parrot, it's fine. He'll be okay. It seems as though we will not find out what happens to the giant green gem. It is time instead to play as the wizard. So what does L do with... Hang on. There, we can pick things up and throw them around, of course. So I don't know exactly what the early access page means when it says it only has two levels, because this is the third level that I'm playing. So I'm not sure if they just forgot how to keep count or what the case may be. But maybe this counts as a tutorial and there's two quote-unquote levels after that. Maybe it means some kind of hub level? I'm not sure. Either way, guys, according to the reviews on the Steam Early Access page, there are at least 1 to 2 hours of gameplay right now. Let's say two, but I can't say that with any guarantee because I haven't played it all myself yet, but I have been having a lot of fun with what I've been playing. Anyways, guys, I want to thank you so much for checking out this video on the newest Trine. Available on Early Access now for $18. Like I said, check it out if you're interested. I think you'll get a lot of fun out of what is here. I'm just hopeful that the updates are not too few and far between. That is my biggest fear. There's nothing like getting into a game when it first comes out like this and then losing interest before it can be done. So if you're worried about that, I would definitely wait. But if you really need to get your fix in now and see what all Trine 3 has in store for you, then please, by all means, take a look down below. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please leave your thoughts down below as well. I would love to see them. Thank you guys for watching. My name is Etalyx, and I hope to see you soon.